William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, also spelled Shakespeare, by name Bard of Avon or Swan of Avon, Baptist April 26, 1564, Stratford upon Avon, Warwickshire, England, died April 23, 1616, Stratford upon Avon, English poet, dramatist and actor, often called the English national poet and considered by many to be the greatest dramatist of all time. Title page of the first folio, the first published edition, 1623, of the collected works of William Shakespeare. It was originally titled Mr. William Shakespeare's Comedies, Histories, Tragedies. Title page of the first folio, the first published edition, 1623, of the collected works of William Shakespeare. It was originally titled Mr. William Shakespeare's Comedies, Histories, Tragedies. Shakespeare occupies a position unique in world literature. Other poets such as Homer and Dante and novelists such as D.L. Tolstoy and Charles Dickens have transcended national barriers, but no writer's living reputation can compare to that of Shakespeare, who plays written in the late 6th and early 17th centuries for a small repertory theater, are now performed and read more often and in more countries than ever before. The prosody of his great contemporary, the poet and dramatist Ben Jonson, that Shakespeare was not at an age but for all time has been fulfilled. It may be odious even to attempt a definition of his greatness, but it's not so difficult to describe the gifts that enabled him to create imaginative visions of pathos and mirth that, whether read or witnessed in the theater, fill the mind and linger there. He is a writer of great intellectual rapidity, perceptiveness, and poetic power. Other writers have had these qualities, but with Shakespeare, the keenness of mind was applied not to abstract or remote subjects, but to human beings and their complete range of emotions and conflicts. Other writers have applied their keenness of mind in this way, but Shakespeare, in astonishingly clever with words and images, saw that this mental energy, when applied to intelligible human situations, finds full and memorable expression, convincing and imaginative stimulating. As if these were not enough, the art form into which his creative energies went was not remote and bookish, but involved the vivid stage impersonation of human beings, commanding sympathy and inviting vicarious participation. Thus, Shakespeare's merits can survive translation into other languages and into cultures remote from that of Elizabeth England. Although the amount of factual knowledge available about Shakespeare is surprisingly large for one of his situation in life, many find it a little disappointing, for it's mostly gleaned from documents of an official character. Days of baptism, marriages, deaths of burials, various conveyance, legal presses, and payments by the court, these are the dusty details. There are, however, many contemporary allusions to him as a writer, and these add a reasonable amount of flesh and blood to Virgil's skeleton.